Hey, what's going on everybody? Chad from Misco Motor Channel. We're out on Clifford for the weekend. It's a gross, gray, drizzly morning in mid-September. Last weekend on the boat, and this morning we're gonna go take the trailer over to the shipyard to drop it off for winter storage. And this weekend, we got Jersey with me, and my dad is with me this weekend, so. We're gonna go over to Skipper Bud's, drop the trailer, and not really planning on doing any boating today because it's not a great day for it, but we might take it out tomorrow. So, see what kind of adventures we can get into today without being on the boat. All right, the trailer is now dropped. Sitting in front of these nice sized sailboats and a big power boat there. This is not where it's going to sit all winter long, but it is now tagged with my name on it. And I also put this on it the other day just for some extra identification, but they're gonna pull it over to the trailer yard at some point today. So the plan is now we're actually going to use the trailer to pull the boat out of the water, pull it over to the building that's gonna be stored in, and then we'll put it on stands in order for me to do the bottom paint. And then when I'm done with that, we'll put it back on the trailer. So. It is a good thing that I ended up doing all the trailer maintenance and getting the bunks replaced and everything because it's gonna be used this winter, so cool. All right, after just dropping the trailer off, I just wanna show you a little bit of the east coast of Door County here. We're obviously not on the boat. This is Whitefish Bay. It is very breezy out today and you can see the waves look like the ocean. Definitely beautiful. So this is a part of Door County that I don't think really gets much attention, even though it's a great place to spend a week or a weekend, even when it's breezy. All right, well, we are on the boat. It is a windy day. You can kind of see my flag up there on the bow. Whipping around a little bit, but that's really not a good example of how windy it actually is. We've got the windows all completely closed on the canvas, and it's howling. What'd you say, it's 19?
19's which, no. Yeah, no, 12.
12 here?
38.
I think so it was 19.
No, 19 was offshore, wasn't it?
22 was offshore. Anyway, it's windy. And we have gone nowhere today, which was the plan. We knew it was going to be windy. And we decided that just the afternoon of hanging out on the boat was the way to go. We went over to friends on another dock. They have a sailboat. Hung out with them for a little bit. And otherwise, just been sitting around hanging out. But, you know, a day on the boat's better than a day not on the boat.
It's profound.
That's profound, right? Yeah, see? Yeah,
he knows.
We got plenty of drinks. I will show you my lights when it gets a little bit darker. They look great. I'm excited about them. Great example of a Door County evening. Friday night. Beautiful sunset. Here's the boat. Right there. All right, so for the fun of it today, since we don't really have anything else to do, and it's really windy again, I'm not sure we're gonna take the boat out today. We came over to Quarter Deck, the other Skipper Bud's marina, and we're walking the docks and just kind of looking around at some boats. I'm hoping that I can spot a Bayliner, 3780 or 3888, as that will be the style of boat that we might be looking at next. So let's see what we can find. Nice big Regal there. mid-sized boat if we were going to stay in the express cruiser category, but this boat we really like. I don't even know what it is. Hey. Quinn. Carver 355. It's pretty cool. Lots of Carvers here. Here's a Carver 28. It is for sale, but it's a little bit smaller than I think what we'll be looking at. Length overall is pretty much the exact same size as our current Regal. Definitely more indoor space, but I'm thinking that we're going to be in this 37, 39, 40 foot range on an older Bayliner style boat. There's another Carver over here, 36 foot. This is an aft cabin, forward cabin boat. That's pretty much the style, but I like the look of the Bayliners better. On the next dock over, no boats at the end of this dock, so I just thought I'd show a view looking down the waterway here. Got a really ugly Sundancer here. Sorry to whoever owns that. Lots more Carvers down this dock. Not spotting my Bayliner yet. Oops. It's taking on some water. That's a nice sailboat. There's a Carver 370, that's getting into the range. But Carvers are out of my price range. But that's about the size and style of the Bayliner. That's a nice looking boat too. Regal on the end here. Again, size of boat if we were gonna step up to the next size and stay in an express cruiser, but I like that. This is an Ocean Alexander. This is D dock. Not really much. Well, there's lots of boats worth filming on this dock, but not for what I'm interested in. Bourbon Street. We are walking down E dock. And we're only not many big boats on this dock, but we're gonna go see what's on E18 just to see what Dad has said is my sister boat. But look at this cute little Ranger tug. It's adorable, kind of like my little tug. Look how clean the water is. It's so clear, I love it. Water up in Door County is nice and clear versus what water's like at home. Disgusting. All right, so E18, a quarter deck, is a red boat. It's a smaller red boat. Chaparral. Cool. And we can walk the dock, might as well. Sailboats down here. That's neat looking. A couple of cool wood sailboats here. At least I think they're all wood. That might be fiberglass hull. Yeah. Cool looking though. Well, kind of struck out on finding a Bayliner this morning. I really thought maybe there'd be one over here, but there's not. Some really nice boats though. All those empty docks over there. Nice house and a big boat over there. Yeesh. All right, well, it's not a bad looking boat. It's still a little bit on the smaller side for what I'd be looking for. This is a Silverton. It's for sale. 32,000. Fly bridge. But just one cabin and probably one bathroom. It's a good looking boat. Boats are out of the water, starting to take up parking spaces. Season's coming to an end. All right, so why am I looking at the Bayliner series, the 38-foot Bayliner series? Well, they're a very, very well-built boat. They're nothing fancy, but for a 38-foot motor yacht that's decently priced, and well built, there's not really nothing else in that class of boat until you step up to, you know, something in the $100,000 plus range for like a Carver 355 or something along those lines. The Bayliner motor yacht series started in 1983 as the 3870. They had Hino, Japanese built Hino diesel engines at 135 horsepower, had two of them. Later in the line, when they switched to the 3888, had 175 horsepower, and I think they also had a 210 horsepower model after they were switched over to US General, which were still built on Hino blocks, still diesels, very, very, very reliable power. Two staterooms, two bathrooms, air conditioning, enclosed saloon, nice size cockpit, 13 and a half foot beam, fly bridge. Just kind of has what I would consider a very nice next step from the boat that I'm currently sitting on, the Regal 2665 Commodore. Want more room? I don't need to go fast. I've kind of discovered over this season that getting somewhere quickly is not really what I'm into boating for. So we've been cruising this boat at 8 to 10 knots regularly, and that will be absolutely perfect for the next boat, a bigger boat that will cruise along at 8 to 10 knots and literally burn like 8 to 10 gallons an hour. Those things will cruise, the older ones will cruise at about 15 top speed. The newer ones with the higher horsepower engines will cruise 16, 18 knots, but still burning, you know, 13 to 15 gallons an hour at that speed, extremely, extremely efficient as well. So that's some of the main reasons that we're looking for, or that I will be looking for replacing this boat with the Bayliner motor yacht series. They were built in Everett, Washington, extremely good quality construction. The stigma with the motor yachts obviously is the name, because it's still associated with Bayliners that you see piled up on the side of the road in terrible condition. The runabouts built completely different. The motor yachts are very, very well built machines, so I don't have any issue with that whatsoever. So very good boats. So I think probably not this year, unless some great deal comes along. But I would imagine that this time next year, fall of 2020, is when I'll start seriously looking at replacing the Express Cruiser with a motor yacht. The 3870 was built originally in 1983, and they built these boats through 1995, finishing up with 3888. And they built about 1,000 of these boats. So over the course of 12 years, building 1,000 boats keeps the price down on the used market. They're just a great value. And there's always some available. So that's one reason I'm not really looking to jump ship, so to speak, on this boat right away. just because I know that this time next year there's going to be several for sale at the same time, so we'll have a selection to look at. Probably have to end up doing some traveling across the country to look at some of these, but you know, that's part of buying a specific type of boat. Unless I get lucky and there's something around Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, something like that, but probably not. We'll see. Just for the fun of it, we decided to come over to the little boat show and go take a look at a couple of these massive boats. We are on board a Cruisers Cantius. I believe this is the 56, right?
Mm-hmm. 50.
Cruisers 50 Cantius. We're going to talk about some living space. This is quite nice. Sunroofs open up. Well, this feels like a hotel. I mean, the floor is like solid. Wow. This is beautiful. Windows right near the waterline. Enclosed shower. Another head. With another shower. Oh, that goes into the mat, that forward V berth. Oh, we got bunks over here. Mm-hmm. Very cool. To the foredeck here on the bow, there's a very nice lounge area. Look at the size of these wipers. They're huge. And those windshields probably cost more than my truck. What a beautiful boat. Way out of my price range, but
it's on sale though.
It is on sale. So the swim platform, the whole platform lowers. Those turn into steps. You can easily launch a tender. Sale show price $1,450,000. Yeah, 220. Fifty-foot boat. We just went for a little walk in our in my own marina here at Harbor Club, and I came across this Cruisers Yachts 3650 motor yacht. It's not for sale, but I'm gonna have to do a little more research on this one. Super wide, big platform, molded steps. That's not a bad looking boat. All right, well, we decided to take the boat out this afternoon. A little breezy, but it's a beautiful day. So this is the last opportunity we're gonna have to take the boat out. Other than a week from now when I pull the boat out of the water, I'll run it down the river just a little bit. But Dad and I are just gonna go out and relax this afternoon for a little while. Jersey's on board back there. And yeah, enjoy this last cruise. Summer is over. Bummer. Oh, I did just find a different boat that I'm gonna start looking into, but it's the Cruisers 3650 motor yacht. Now this one I just found in the in our own marina. Had no idea that it was there, but went over and looked at it this afternoon. No idea how much they cost on the East Market, but it's one that I want to take a look at in addition to the Bayliner 3888. So. I'd rather be back up there flying airplanes or on a boat.
Where'd it go? There it is.
My answer consistently, always on a boat. It's way more relaxing. I love it. Coming back into the dock for the last time this season. I will leave the dock one more time, obviously, to take the boat out of the water, but this is it. Last cruise of the season. Beautiful day for it, though. So, the Cruisers 3650 that I just learned about today, this could be a potential competitor with the Bayliner 3888 that I've had my eyes on for the last couple of months. Again, nothing is happening this year. We're probably talking next year, next fall, before I seriously start looking. The Cruisers Yachts 3650 kind of picked up where the Bayliner 3888 left off in 1995. It was produced from 95 to 2005. Came with a variety of engine packages. The base model had 7.4 Mercurys on it, 454s, 310 horsepower. You could get it with 375 twin 375s. You get it with diesel engines as well. So that's kind of intriguing. It's a full two stateroom boat with two heads, air conditioning and interior space, fully enclosed interior space as well. However, this boat being a little bit newer is a little bit more expensive. Looking around lately, I've been seeing prices in the low 60s up to 105. So not sure I can swing that, but you know, if the right deal came along, you never know. So it's a great looking boat. I don't think it's as good looking as the Bayliner. For some reason, the Bayliner has a really nice classic look to it for me, and I really, really like it. But you know, I have to think of interior space and use and, parts. Cruisers is literally across the bay from me, where I keep the boat. It's in the same state. They're made in Wisconsin. We'll see. So yeah, that's just another option that came up as of today, and we'll take a look at them and see what's out there. So, all right. Well, I just realized that I didn't end this video on the boat. So, back home, Packers win. Good weekend. Just a great weekend, actually. So I'm sorry I didn't wrap this up on the boat in the first place. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching the video. Boat's coming out of the water this next week, and I'll make a video of that as well. So thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time, and happy boating!